First of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. M. A. R.G., Assistant Professor, Department of Rasashastra and Vaishya Kalpana, Global Institute of Ayurveda. Today, I'm going to be talking about Kshara Varga, alkaline group of drugs or preparation of plant cauterizers. The points to be discussed under this topic are its introduction, definition, general method of preparation, Kshara classification and its significance. The detailed description of this Kshara Kalpana, you will get it from Susruta Samhita. In Susruta Samhita, Acharya explained the application of Kshara in different diseases like Bhagandhara, Vrana, Gulma, Udavarta, etc. like disease conditions. Anyway, at present, the Kshara Sutra treatment has gained popularity in the management of fistula in ano, sinus wounds, piles, warts, etc. I will begin with the introduction part, that is the meaning of word Kshara. Literal meaning of the word Kshara is, it is a substance which is having corrosive, caustic, pungent, saline and acid properties. Corrosion here means the gradual consummation of a substance by another, especially by biochemical or chemical reactions. Its definitions are also explained in classics. Shabdakalpadruma, it's the word Kshara is explained as Ksharati iti Kshara. Kshara is the substance which possesses Kshara property, that means which mobilize and remove the deformed body tissues. In Susruta Samhita, Acharya explained the definition of Kshara as Tatra Kshranath Kshananat va Kshara. Kshara is a substance which easily removes the deformed body tissues and easily which will mobilize these body tissues, deformed body tissues. By virtue of its Chedana and Bhedana Karma, it is also called as Anushastra. And according to Susruta Samhita, Acharya explained, if a clever physician who administers the Kshara properly means it will cure all the severe ailments rapidly. Anyway, we will see some of the significance of Kshara. Kshara is significant among Shastra and Anushastra since it is useful in the case of surgical contraindications. It suits better for women, children and for those who are afraid of surgery. It can be used as Anushastra, which helps in controlling the bleeding and which reduces the chance of disease recurrence and wound infections. Let's see the classifications of Kshara. Classifications or the grouping of the Kshara is in four headings. It is explained under four headings. First three classifications are based on their usage, source of origin and their strength. And the last classification is based on their groups, that is identified in certain groups. Anyway, first we will discuss these classifications, each classification detail. First classification, that is according to or depending on their usage, it is classified into two types, Paniyakshara and Pratisaraniyakshara. Paniyakshara, which is used for internal purpose, for example Kshara Udaga is there, that can be used internally, that is Paniyakshara. Second variety is Pratisaraniyakshara, that is based on their usage, it is classified into two, Paniya for internal purpose and Pratisaraniya for external usage. For external usage, again three classifications are there, that is according to the strength of this Kshara, it is classified into three, that is Mrudu, Madhyama, Teshna Kshara, that we will discuss into another classification. Anyway, this Pratisarana Kshara is also classified under three headings, that is Mrudu, Madhyama and Teshna Kshara, that is according to their strength it can be used according to different conditions. The next classification is depending on their source of origin. Based on their source of origin, it is classified into three groups, that is Khanija, Pranija and Vanaspadika Kshara. Khanija Kshara, the source of origin is from mineral origin. It is having mineral source of origin and again it is classified into two groups, Naisargika and Kritrima. Now some of the examples for this Naisargika, Khanija Kshara are Sarja Kshara, Surya Kshara, Tangana Kshara, etc. And the second variety coming under this Khanijakshara is Krithrimakshara. Sodium borate is coming under this group. Anyway, Khanijakshara, which is obtained from mineral source, it is again classified into Naisargika and Krithrima. Second variety is Pranijakshara, which is obtained from animal source. Some of the examples of this Pranijakshara are Shanga, Shukti, Varadika, Pravala, etc. Third variety is Vanaspadika Kshara. Vanaspadika Kshara is the Kshara which is obtained from plant source. Some examples are Chinchakshara, Arkakshara, Palakshakshara, etc. Anyway, based on their source of origin, this Kshara is classified into three groups: Khanijakshara, Pranijakshara, and Vanaspadika Kshara. Third classification is, we already discussed it under Pratisaraniya Kshara, that is depending on their strength, it is classified into three groups: Mrudu, Madhyama, and Tikshna Kshara. Mrudu Kshara is having mild Kshara property, Madhyama is having moderate Kshara property, and the Tikshna Kshara is having high Kshara property, which can be obtained during the time of preparation of this Kshara Kalpana. It can be, the strength can be, we can prepare according to their usage, that is Mrudu, Madhyama, and Tikshna Kshara. The last one is the classification which is identified in certain groups. Basically, the Kshara is classified in two groups. They are called Kshara Dvaya or Dvikshara. They are Sarja Kshara and Evakshara. Dvikshara or Kshara Dvaya, the Kshara which are coming under this category are Sarja Kshara and Evakshara. If Tangana is added to this group, it is called as Kshara Triga or Trikshara. They are Sarjakshara, Yavakshara and Tangana Kshara. Next classification is Kshara Panchaka. Kshara Panchaka or five types of Kshara classification. This is explained in Rasatarangini. Detailed description of this five types and eight types of Kshara you will get it from Rasatarangini. Acharya explained it as, for Kshara Panchaka, the drugs which are categorized under this group are Mushkaga Kshara, Yavakshara, Kimshuga Kshara Evacha, Swarjiga Kshara, Tilakshara, Kshara Panchaga Muchyate. Mushkaga Kshara, Yavakshara, Kimshuga, Swarjiga and Tilakshara are classified under the Kshara Panchaga. That is five varieties of Kshara. Kshara can be prepared from these plant or mineral substances. Next is Kshara Ashtaga, eight types of Kshara Varga. That also classified under Rasa Tarangini, Sutha Palasha Shigari, Chinja Arka Tila Nalaja, Swarjiga, Yava Shugashtra, Kshara Ashtaga Mudaharata. Eight types of Kshara, which is classified under this Kshara Ashtaga category is Sutha, Palasha, Shikari, Chinja, Arka, Tila Nala, Swarjiga Kshara and Yava Shuga or Yavakshara is the Kshara which are classified under Kshara Ashtaga. These are the classifications explained for Kshara or Kshara types classification, which is explained in four headings, that is based on their usage it is classified into Paniya and Pratisaraniya. Depending on their source of origin it is classified into Khanija, Pranija and Vanaspadika. In Khanija also two varieties are there, Naisargika and Krithrima. And remaining classification, that is depending on their strength, it is classified into Mrudu, Madhyama, Tikshna Kshara, and it is also identified in certain groups. They are Dvikshara, Trikshara, Kshara Panchaka and Kshara Ashtaga. Anyway, these are the classifications which are detailed explained in classical textbooks. Next, we will see the method of preparation of Kshara. General method of preparation. The references of this method of preparation are found in different classical textbooks, in Charaka, Sushruta, Ashtangrida, Sharangra Samhita, Rasatarangini. Almost all textbook you will get the detailed description of method of preparation of all the Kshara Kalpana is there. Anyway, we will follow the reference from Paribhasha Pratibhika, that is the method of preparation of Kshara. For this method of preparation, certain steps are there. That is explained in classics as Kshara Vrikshasya Panjangam Shushkamagno Pradipayet Nitva Tat Bhasma Mrutpatre Kshiptva Niretu Shadgume Vimardya Thareyet Gatro Pradaracham Jalam Naye Eka Vimshati Varavstat Vasasa Sraveyet Jalam Tan Niram Kvadeyet Vaknav Yavat Sarvam Vishushyati Tadaha Patrat Samullikya Kshara Grahya Sita Prabaha. This is the reference from Paribhasha Pradeepika. We are following the same reference for the method of preparation of kshara. Just see the picture, you will get the detailed description in a picture depiction. You will get it from this slide. Anyway, first you have to select the plant for the kshara karma. According to the utility, you have to first select the plant for the kshara karma, and afterwards it should be that also collected in appropriate season. All the panchanga should be collected in appropriate season, that is root, stem, leaves, flower and fruit should be collected. Afterwards it should be entirely dried under hot sun. See the picture. The panchanga of the drug should be dried under sun. When it completely dries, it is cut into smaller pieces and ignited in an open place. When it completely dries, it should be cut into smaller pieces and ignited in an open place. After the drug is completely burned, the ash is allowed to cool down on its own. And if it is necessary, means the plant ash is filtered through a sieve to get rid of unburned woody part. See the picture. So you obtained ash is there. And next step is, this obtained ash filtrate is dissolved in certain quantity of water. That also different references are there. According to Yogaratnagara, according to Rasatarangini, different references are explained. 6 parts and 4 parts are there. According to your utility, you can dissolve it in either 6 parts or 4 parts of water. Or otherwise, it can be dissolved in cow's urine or mixture of both. These are the references explained in Yogaratnagara and Rasatarangini. Commonly, we used to filter it in, dissolve it in 6 parts of water. And afterwards, this mixture is stirred well. Then it is kept undisturbed overnight. Afterwards, next morning, this supernatant clear liquid is carefully decanted into a separate clean vessel. See the picture. After dissolving, it should be kept for overnight. Then the next day, the supernatant water should be clearly decanted into separated vessel. The next step is, it is then filtered through a clean cotton cloth. That should be either 3-folded or 4-folded cloth should be taken, and it is to be filtered through this cloth for 21 times. Specification of this 21 times filtration is perhaps to obtain the purest form of kshara. It means when it, the Samyak Lakshana for this is explained as, when it attains Gomutra Varna, we can stop the filtration. Anyway, we have to filter it for 21 times. The final filtrate is taken into an open large iron vessel and boiled with a constant stirring. When the boiling liquid turns brown, slimy, clear and pungent smelling, it is then removed from fire and allowed to settle. This clear supernatant liquid is carefully decanted again, and this decanted liquid is called ksharodaka. Ksharodaka we discussed under, depending on their usage, it is classification we discussed, that is paniya kshara and pratisarana kshara. This ksharodaka can be used for internal purpose, that is classified as paniya kshara. This decanted liquid is called ksharodaka. It can be used for both pharmaceutical as well as therapeutic procedures. And afterwards, this obtained ksharodaka alone is subjected for further boiling to get in paste or dry powder form. This is called as mridu kshara. This is the first stage. That much strength is not there. Anyway, this first stage kshara is called as mridu kshara. If it is needed, means you can convert it into either moderate, that is madhyama kshara, or tikshna kshara. For converting it into madhyama kshara, it is said that this obtained ksharodaka is again subjected for further boiling by adding the drugs such as sudha, shanga, shukti, in powder, dried powder form, it should be added to this kshaarodaka. Then it will be converted into madhyama kshara. That means some of the teekshna dravyas you can add to convert it into madhyama and teekshna kshara. This obtained kshaarodaka, again if you want to convert this into teekshna kshara, means this obtained kshara can be again subjected for further boiling by adding all the drugs which are used for madhyama kshara, and along with that fine powders of the herbal drugs like dandi, dravandi, chitraga, langali, hingu, and some of the mineral drugs like pravala, vidalavana, savarsalavana to the kshaarodaka in paste or dry powder form. This form of kshara is called teekshna kshara. Anyway, all these additional drugs are added in the ratio of 1/10th part of the total drug ash used for this kshara preparation. And before using this sudha or limestone, it should be burned. And these are the method of preparation explained in classics for kshara kalpana. And one more thing is there. Acharya differently explained the detailed description for the adding of the additional drugs for converting it into madhyama and teekshna kshara. That is, 1/3 part of kshaarodaka is taken separately in a vessel first. Then specified mineral drugs are heated into red hot, that is sudha. Everything should be, pravala shukti should be burned first and dipped repeatedly until they converted into powder form. And at this stage the herbal drugs are added in fine powders form. Anyway, these additional drugs are expected to increase the potency and convert it into madhyama and teekshna kshara. This is the preparation method of kshara kalpana explained in classics. If needed, you can convert it into madhyama and teekshna kshara. Anyway, the procedure is like that. See the picture here, it is clearly depicted. First you have to collect all the panchangas, it should be dried properly, then it is to be burned and converted into ash afterwards with specified ratio, that is sthapana should be done in 6 parts of water, and then galana should be done, and afterwards 21 times of filtration is explained. Samyak lakshana is also gomutra. When it attains gomutra varna, the boiling should be started. When it converts into completely powder form, it can be stored inside an airtight container. This is the general method of preparation of kshara kalpana. Properties also explained by different acharyas differently. According to Susruta, he explained the prepared kshara should not be too teekshna and not too mild. They should be in white color, should be smooth in nature, slimy in nature, and non-spreading in nature. The quality is explained by Acharya Susruta. Mrutu, Shukla, Slakshna, Apichila, Abhishyandi. These are some of the characteristic features explained by Susruta. And by Charaka, he explained the Shara should possess Tishna, Ushna, Laku, Ruksha, Kleti, Vrana, Vitaraka properties. And according to Rasa Tarangini, the properties like Tishna, Ushna, and Dahagaraka, along with the, it is indicated in Gulma, Grahani, Pliha, Mutra, Vrasra, etc. like conditions also added by Rasa Tarangini. The dosage of this kshara is explained as 2 to 8 gunja. For all types of kshara, it is explained that it can be given in the dosage of 2 to 8 gunja. And that its shelf life is, as per the modern protocol, if we are storing it in a proper airtight container, means it can be stored for 5 years in suitable conditions. And some examples for this kshara are Apamarga, Snuhi, Kadali, Vashakshara, etc. Anyway, according to your utility, you can select the Panchanga of kshara. If it is herbal, means select the Panchanga of kshara. Otherwise, if it's mineral source, means you can collect it and try it properly and prepare the kshara according to the therapeutic utility. This is all about kshara kalpana introduction part. We discussed its introduction, its significance, classification, and general method of preparation. We will see the individual description of each kshara later on slides.